Hi to all, welcome to Biochem Talk. In this video, discuss about lymphoid organs. Lymphoid organs of immune system protects our body from infection. Lymphoid organs are of two types, primary and secondary lymphoid organs. Primary lymphoid organs are thymus and bone marrow. They form lymphocytes. Lymphocytes in primary lymphoid organs are inactive as they do not come in contact with antigen. Secondary lymphoid organs are lymph nodes, spleen and mucosa associated lymphoid tissue like appendix, Peyer's patches and tonsils. In secondary lymphoid organs, lymphocytes become active on contact with antigen. Thymus is the primary lymphoid tissue in which T cells get developed and mature. Thymus is situated above the heart. It has two lobes. It is surrounded by capsule. The capsule is invaginated to form clavicula, which divide lobe into lobules. The cortex, the outer region, is densely populated with immature thymocytes, and medulla, the inner region, is sparsely populated with mature thymocytes. In addition to thymocytes, thymus contains dendrite cells, macrophages, and epithelial cells. The group of epithelial cells form partial corpuscles in the middle of the thymus. T cells helps to form mature T cells. During maturation, T cell receptors are formed on the surface of T cells. Thymus kills the T cells, which react with self antigen. Thymus activity decreases with increase in age. The bone marrow is a soft tissue found within the bone. It synthesizes the B cells. Similar to thymus, bone marrow kills the B cells, which react with self antigen. This activity also decreases with increase in age. In birth, B cells are formed and get matured in the bursa of Fabricius, a lymphoid associated with gut. The lymph node. It is a well-organized secondary lymphoid organ. It is present near the joints and the regions where arms and legs join in the body. It is bean-shaped, helps to remove antigen present in the lymph. Several afferent lymphatic vessels carries lymph to the lymph node, and a single efferent lymphatic vessel carries lymph away from the lymph node. Lymph node is surrounded by capsule. It has three regions, outer cortex, middle paracortex, and inner medullary region. The cortex is densely populated with B cells. These cells are grouped together to form primary follicle. On immune response, germinal center is developed in primary follicle and forms secondary follicle. In addition to lymphocyte, lymph node contains dendrite cells, which helps to process antigen. Medulla is sparsely populated with B and T cells. They are present in the medullary cord, which are separated by medullary sinus. Antigen from the tissues carried by afferent lymphatic vessel to the lymph node. Dendrite cells and phagocytic cells process the antigen, which activate lymphocytes in the paracortex region. Activated lymphocytes migrate to the primary follicle of the cortex. On immune response, primary follicle is converted to secondary follicle. Antibodies generated in the secondary follicle moves to the medulla. Thus, antigens are actively removed by the lymph node. Spleen is a secondary lymphoid organ. It is present in the left abdominal region. It is oval shaped. It removes antigen present in the blood. Spleen is surrounded by capsule, which divides the spleen into compartments by trabecula. The compartments are divided into red pulp and white pulp. Red pulp contains erythrocyte, lymphocyte, and macrophages. Spleen destroys and removes the defective erythrocyte by macrophages. The white pulp surrounds the splenic artery is called periarterial lymphoid sheath, which is enriched with T cells. Outside periarterial lymphoid sheath, marginal zone is present, which contains the primary follicle and which is enriched with the B cells. On antigenic stimulation, B cells secrete antibodies and kills the antigen. Mucosal membrane lining the digestive and respiratory and urogenital system is called mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. These are similar to lymph node in structure but not encapsulated as lymph node. They are tonsils, Peyer's patches and appendix. Tonsils are found in four locations: lingual at the base of the tongue, palatine at the size of the back of the mouth, tubal at the opening of the eustachian tube, and pharyngeal at the roof of the nasopharynx. Tonsils contain lymphocytes and macrophages. It prevents the entry of pathogen through nasopharynx. Peyer's patches are the lymphoid tissue present throughout the ileum region of the small intestine. Outer mucosal epithelial layer contains T lymphocytes, the lamina propria, which present under this epithelial layer contains B cells, T helper cells, and macrophages. Submucosal layer beneath the lamina propria contains primary follicle, which may develop into secondary follicle on immune response. Peyer's patches showed immune response when it is exposed to antigen. The antigen is carried by M cells, which is present in the inductive site of the intestinal luminal membrane. It activates the lymphocyte present in the luminal membrane, which in turn activates the lymphoid follicles in the lamina propria. The activated B cells secret IgE antibodies, which transport across the luminal membrane and released into the intestinal lumen, from where it interacts with the antigen. Appendix is present at the junction of the small and large intestine. It is a storage of the good bacteria and reboots the digestive system after diarrhea. Appendicitis is the inflamed appendix due to the blockage in the appendix. It is caused by the viral infection, parasitic infection, and tumor. The blockage decreases blood flow and increases pressure and inflammation in the appendix. The standard treatment is the removal of appendix. The removal of appendix does not cause any adverse effect. Thank you.